Magic mushrooms. We know what they do, but how do they work? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and you know what fascinates me the most about science? The fact that we're still learning new information on things that have been around for thousands of years. Take psychedelic mushrooms, or psilocybin mushrooms. These have been around since the prehistoric times. There's even a theory called the stoned ape theory, which proposes that humans evolved from early primates through the use of psychedelic mushrooms. They've been used in religious ceremonies all over the world for centuries, and it's suggested that the use of mushrooms and other psychedelic drugs are what formed the basis of modern religion. Today, people use them mostly recreationally, and while the effects of mushrooms are pretty well known, what's not well known is how they actually work. Until now. A new study published in Human Brain Mapping finds that psilocybin, the active chemical in psychedelic mushrooms, is closely tied to the parts of our brains that help us dream. Now, logically, this makes sense. Psychedelic drugs are notorious for transporting users into a heightened state of consciousness, which explains why they're often used in a spiritual context. The part of our brains that gets activated during dream sleep are tied to the brain's ancient emotion system. And when someone takes psychedelic drugs, that area of the brain becomes uninhibited, so their emotions seem to get louder. What's interesting is that the ego system, the part of the brain that gives us our sense of self, actually gets quieter and more disjointed under the effects of psychedelics. So it's believed that the quieting of that ego system is what allows our emotional system to become louder. According to the author of the study, Dr. Robin Carhart Harris, psychedelics cause ego dissolution, meaning they temporarily diminish one's sense of having a firm and enduring personality. At the same time, they widen the breadth of associations made throughout the brain, which is what enhances our creativity and causes that state of expanded consciousness. That also explains why they're sometimes used in psychotherapy, because they help patients facilitate an emotional release. Speaking of emotional releases, I am sure many of you heard the recent news about Hobby Lobby and the Supreme Court ruling allowing them to deny contraception coverage to their employees. At the risk of alienating half of our audience, I will keep my opinions to myself on this one, but I do want to remind everyone that we have a new show called Test Tube, hosted by Trace and myself, that is a lot like DNews, but focused more on current events. We've got a new episode up where Trace talks all about the Hobby Lobby ruling and what it means for America, so if you were looking to learn more about that situation, we would love it if you checked out that show. You can find that episode and many more over at youtube.com/testtubenetwork. In the meantime, if you've got any questions, comments, anything you want to say about this episode or psychedelic drugs in general, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.